Hi, this is Robert coming to you with another car care video. And the reason I'm bringing you these videos is because I want you to know that your car should last at least 200,000 miles without any major breakdowns or maintenance requirements. I've had cars, even the one I'm driving now, have more than 200,000 miles. I wouldn't hesitate to drive it across country. I also have had cars that had over 400,000 miles. So I want to help you understand how to get the best out of your car. Now today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about head gaskets. Head gaskets is a word that you never want to hear if you're a car owner. Normally when people think about head gaskets, they talk about a bad head gasket. A bad head gasket basically means that there's no longer a good seal between the head of your motor and the block of your motor. The block of your motor holds the pistons, the head of your motor holds the valves and things, and there's coolant and oil that travel between the two. And when that seal goes bad, you often have major problems, and most people call that a blown engine. What I have here in my hand is a head gasket. It's like an aluminum thing with maybe a rubber coating on it, some kind of coating on it. And as you can see, there's five holes in this head gasket, and these five holes represent the amount of cylinders this car has. So the car that I'm working on now is my daughter's beloved S70 Volvo, and it's a five-cylinder turbocharged car. Now generally, you'll never have to worry about a head gasket blowing in your car unless something causes it. There's three or four things that generally cause a head gasket failure. The number one cause is a water pump goes out. You're driving down the road, you're not paying attention to the instrument gauge, the water pump goes out, it stops the circulation of water, the motor overheats, and the light in the motor that tells you it's overheating doesn't come on until it's too late. You see a light, you look down, try to figure out what's going on, your temperature gauge is already in the red, so you try to get to a safe place and pull over, or you try to make it to where you're going. Let me give you a secret. You will never make it to where you're going. If you ever see your temperature needle go toward the red or close to that red, pull that car over immediately, cut it off. If it gets in that red, that's when the head of the car warps and takes a different form, and it allows the head gasket to lose a good seal. That's how you end up with a bad head gasket. Now, if you look in the motor here, you will see this shiny part. That's the part to the head. I've already gotten that back from the shop. They resurfaced it, cleaned it up, and that's the head. Under this line right here is the motor block. That dark part down here is the block of the motor. That's the part that has the pistons in it. So you got your head on top of the block and that gasket in between. Now what you're looking at here is your valves. If anybody ever tells you that you have bad valve seals, there's seals in these little middle rods in there, and when those leak, you'll normally burn oil and maybe blow a little smoke out your tailpipe. That's when you have bad valve seals. So that's a little bit about the head. This car also has lifters that'll go on top of those valve seals. Then the cams will sit on top of those two tracks. The timing belt will hook up to that, and then this part will cover all of that, which is the head cover. Some people call it the valve cover. And as you can see, it has a little spout on it that you put your oil in, and it has the five holes that go down to the spark plug. So I'm in the process of putting this car back together, and this car had a strange head gasket breach. Like I said, your number one cause of head gasket failure is a water pump goes out. Your number two cause of a bad head gasket is a coolant leak. I'm going to encourage you now to open your hood at least once a month and check all the fluid. Check your brake fluid, your coolant level, your oil, once a month whether you want to or not. Because if that coolant gets low and it starts to run where there's not enough coolant in the motor, it'll cause the motor to overheat when you're not looking, and then you'll get a bad head gasket. Your average head gasket job cost about $2,800. Anywhere as low as $1,800, which is a rare occasion. On the high end, I've heard of a guy paying $5,200 for a head gasket job. Basically, he could have just about got a new motor for that. But anyway, it's rebuilding a motor. That's why it's so expensive. Now, this car had a minor head gasket leak. I say minor because this had a head gasket leak for at least 6 months. There's major causes. Water pump goes bad. You get a coolant leak. Or somebody installed the head gasket and didn't do everything perfect. If you do something wrong or not perfect in installing these head gaskets, it's going to leak. It's got a lot of pressure in there, a lot of heat in there. And this one, what was happening was, my daughter got in the car one day, started it up, and she looked down, and she seen she had a low coolant light. So she said she didn't have any coolant with her. That's something she better deal with. So she started driving the car. 2 or 3 miles later, the light went out. So she hunched her shoulders and thought, well, maybe it wasn't low. The car cooled off. She got in it, started again, no coolant light. And then she drove around a little bit, the light went out. Well, that was a strange occurrence. So she called me. I said, hey, when the car is cold, look at the level. If it's low, go get some and add some when the car is cold. So she did that. Well, this kept happening. A few weeks later, the light came on again. She added some more. 3 or 4 weeks later, the light came on again. She added some more. Well, when we got together, we tried to determine what was happening. So when she got home, we got in the car and took the car for a ride. And when it was cold, it was at the minimum mark. We drove 3 or 4 miles, pulled over and checked it. It was at the maximum mark. Well, that's strange. How could it get added? We drove 3 or 4 miles. It was totally to the top where the cap is, and coolant was oozing out of the cap. Now, these caps have a pressure relief valve. If too much pressure builds up, they relieve the pressure and let coolant out or let air out. Well, in this case, the head gasket was leaking just a little bit, and it was allowing combustion gases to escape the piston area once the motor got hot, and it was forcing hot combustion air into the passages of the coolant area. Well, that was causing the coolant to boil over, and it was forcing the coolant out of the motor. So she was losing coolant. Well, this was because it had a bad head gasket. Another way you can have a bad head gasket is for your radiator to fail. Your radiator fail either gets plugged up, which is rare, or it springs a leak. You break a hose, that'll cause a leak. You know, those are classified under coolant leaks. So anytime you have a coolant leak, you need to get it taken care of. Because a small coolant leak that may cost you $20, or a radiator leak which may cost you $250, can lead to a $2,800 repair on your car. Take care of those coolant leaks. It's just not worth it. Now, what happened to my daughter is, she went on a trip and she didn't check the coolant before she left. The light went out. She drove the car. It pretty much ran out of coolant, ruptured a hose, and then she seen the level going up. Right as it got to the red, she pulled over, stopped the car, and let it cool off, added some water. She had distilled water from a water bottle or spring water. She drove, got the hose fixed, filled the system back up with coolant, and she was able to drive another 700 miles, even though the car pretty much overheated. Well, it didn't blow the head gasket. It didn't get so hot that it warped the head and caused the leak. But if you talk to most people, about 90% of them, maybe 95% of them, when they talk about a head gasket leak, they will talk about the leaks where the oil is mixing with the coolant, it's blowing smoke out the tailpipe, the car's running real rough. And if you try to drive a car where the oil and the coolant is mixing, sooner or later, you're going to blow the engine, lock up a piston, and destroy some valves. So it's a short-term thing driving with a bad head gasket. But if you have a strange one, like we had, you can get ahead of it. And if you keep cooling in it, you can continue to drive the car until you're able to get the head gasket fixed. So, a bad head gasket, especially on an old car, can sometimes total a car out. So there you go. If you have a coolant reservoir that's giving you a low coolant light, but when you drive a few minutes, the light goes out, you could have a bad head gasket like we had. But at any rate, that's a little bit about head gaskets, how they happen. And even with putting those head gaskets, the head bolts to the block with these long bolts. These bolts are torqued real tight, and they actually stretch when you're putting them in. So it's kind of rare to have a head gasket leak, but if you have a leak, I'm telling you, you either had a bad water pump, you had a coolant leak, or somebody didn't put it in properly last time. And I'm pretty sure that this head was done shortly before we bought the car. So that's all I got about head gaskets. If you have any questions, feel free to ask.